So the most common causes of cardiac arrest are presented as H's and T's. The H's stand for hypovolemia, which can be corrected many times with fluid replacement, hypoxia, which can be corrected with appropriate oxygenation and perfusion of tissues, hydrogen ion or acidosis, either respiratory or metabolic, and if it's respiratory, we can fix it with oxygen and respirations. But if it's metabolic, we may need sodium bicarbonate. Hypo or hyperkalemia. If hypo, we may need to administer potassium. If it's hyper, we may need to administer calcium chloride. Remember that with hypokalemia, we may see flat T waves or maybe something called U waves on the ECG. And if so, we would administer potassium or magnesium per the protocol. And the last of the H's, hypothermia. Now for the T's. They're comprised of tension pneumothorax, which could be relieved with a needle decompression and later a chest tube, cardiac tamponade, which would require surgical therapy, toxins, and lastly, a pulmonary or coronary thrombosis. Pulmonary requiring a corrective procedure or thrombolytic therapy, and the same is applicable for coronary, but additionally, treatment to include percutaneous coronary intervention, commonly called PCI, may be required. It's important to note that the most common causes of PEA are hypoxia and hypovolemia and are potentially reversible. It's vital that we look for evidence of these problems as we assess our patients.